What's up, everybody? If you want to see a sick-ass temple and a life-altering feeding frenzy, you've come to the right place. Welcome to Narita-san, a sick-ass temple complex in Narita, Japan. This place has a wide variety of Japanesey things to see, and personally, I think it's pretty nice. I mean, check out this temple gateway, for example. There's a shitload of shoes popping off on this wall. I don't exactly know why. I guess it must be some kind of Eastern thing. I mean, up here we got some huge footwear, but then on the side we got some smaller footwear hanging around. We even got some conventional shoes. In other words, nice fucking footwear right there. What else we got around here? We got some massive pagoda action. We've got some old school architecture popping off. We've got a pretty nice fountain blasting away. And last but not least, we have some kawaii as fuck Buddhas sporting some buck wild bibs. I don't exactly know why they're wearing bibs. I guess they must be preparing to chow down like wild enlightened individuals possessed. Anyway, I started to check out some side trail action. I must have been walking through some kind of cemetery because I saw some serious stones erected all over the place. Anyway, I kept following those side trails and eventually I came across a pond of sorts. It seemed like a pretty peaceful pond. A real peaceful pond. Only thing was, I saw some wild ripples cutting through the water at a frenzied pace. So I came closer to the water to investigate when I suddenly realized this pond was teeming with wild packs of Japanese carp. It's a pretty sweet-ass pond over here. We got all kinds of fish in this pond, all different kinds. Seems to me like these fish are sporting some pretty nice color combos, and I think they're looking majestic as fuck. We got a whitefish over here hanging around, and I think he's taking a liking to me, and wow, just wow, I could have sworn he just winked at me. Now he's opening his mouth and swimming away, and holy shit, that fish just boosted on out of here. Call me crazy, but I think that fish was trying to send me a message. That fish was staring a hole through my soul, and I think he was trying to communicate to me that him and his friends were feeling hungry as hell. In other words, it's time for a sweet-ass motherfucking feeding frenzy. So I grabbed a cracker out of my bag and crunched it up into bite-sized pieces. What can I say? I'm a nice guy like that. Alright, so I threw that cracker in. I've got pigeons flying around to the left and right side of me. The fish are starting to notice, and holy shit, those fish just started going ballistic. In my personal opinion, that's a nice fucking feeding frenzy right there. Those fish are making a mad dash to chow down at a feverish pace. This shit is no holds barred over here. These fish are getting pretty aggressive about this cracker. I mean, hell, this shit's so serious we even got a turtle joining the fray. If that ain't a top-notch feeding frenzy, then I don't know what is. Anyway, I started to head on back when I was approached by a stray cat. I don't know what the deal is with these animals. Maybe they think I'm a walking food dispenser. Maybe they think I'm a cheap cracker whore. Whatever the case, I'm willing to give away one more of my crackers. Just one more. So here we go. We got the cat investigating the cracker. Does he like the cracker? And wow. Just fucking wow. I guess I shouldn't be surprised. I've seen my fair share of racist cats in Japan. Anyway, I figured I had enough feeding frenzy action for one day, so I decided to hightail it the hell out of that temple complex. So thanks for watching this video. Why don't you leave a comment? Let me know what you think.